This is my homemade air gun, and I want to see if I can put some of these peanut M&Ms through a piece of plywood with it.
Every time I've posted something about this air gun, people have suggested that I use a sprinkler valve instead of a ball valve, but this actually opens really fast. I've got this spring with this thing here, and then there's actually a little bit of slack here, so the spring can accelerate before it yanks the valve open. So let's film that at 400 frames a second. And I took the gun barrel off and put a block of wood here, so I can also see when the air starts to flow. At 400 frames a second, it only takes a few frames. So now at 1200 frames per second, and let's play that again really slowly. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. At 1200 frames per second, that's 4 milliseconds. Way faster than a sprinkler valve.
All right, now to load this gun, I need some wadding. I'm just gonna use a piece of paper towel. And some edible ammo. I'll pick a blue one. And I gotta close that valve, but first I have to cock the trigger mechanism. 100 psi. And here we go. I'll try my best Finnish accent. Well, this is where it hit. And it caused some damage on the other side, but didn't make it through.
Let's just try hitting that same spot again.
Well, I got the wadding stuck in the hole. And by the looks of it, I'm pretty sure that made it through. Let's check the high-speed footage. Well, there wasn't anything that bounced, but no trace of my projectile. It seems to just have evaporated. Although, looking here, there seems to be some very soft stuff stuck to it. Maybe that's chocolate fragments. Yeah, that's gotta be the chocolate down here. It seems kinda silly to have to hit the same spot 3 times. So I figure let's try some thinner plywood. This is 3 millimeter Baltic birch. And just for reference, my distance to target is 49 centimeters.
Even at 1200 frames per second, the only thing you can see flying out is the wadding.
Let's see. Oh, wadding stuck in there. That definitely looks like it went through. Let's see. Well, as usual, no sign of the projectile. So for my high-speed footage, I couldn't really tell how fast that M&M was, so I set something up here. I've got 70 centimeters from here to here, and Lego Man is going to catch the M&M. And I've got a dark background, and the camera here. And my wadding is a piece of black cloth, and then a yellow M&M for maximum visibility. That didn't go so well for Lego Man. Here's his legs. Oh, there's the head. Still smiling.
So looking at the 1200 frames per second footage, I think that M&M is traveling slower than I had it before. There's also an awful lot of blow-by coming out of the barrel before it comes out, so I think that black wadding wasn't very good. So I tried it again with the paper towel wadding. On the high speed, the only thing you can really see flying is the wadding, but I assume that's at least as fast as the M&M.
So here's 4 of the frames at 1200 frames per second. I can't really see the M&M, just this, and I think that's the wadding, but the front edge of that from here to here is 30 centimeters over 1/1200th of a second is 360 meters per second, so the wadding was definitely going supersonic. But I see a trace of something here, and that could be the M&M getting ahead of the wadding. So the M&M may have been faster, and I have to redo that experiment.
This time, measuring the speed of the M&M way away from the gun barrel, and I also have a scale close to the flight path. That way the wadding should be way behind.
So after about a meter, the M&M had definitely separated from the wadding, which is here. And looking at the trailing edge of it from here to here, again, one frame, is 32 centimeters. And that works out to 384 meters per second or 1260 feet per second or Mach 1.1.
I think when it has the opportunity to make an impact crater in a piece of wood like that, the chocolate kind of reforms itself to fit that crater, because this is not the radius of the original M&M. And now let's just smash some stuff for fun. There's a smell of chocolate in the air. And I guess the projectile got disintegrated before it got to this one. This stuff is really brittle. So that was with a marble, which is much slower, but actually has much more punch to it because it's much heavier. And there's just a small exit hole. Went through all of these and then hit here, leaving an impact divot right there. I don't know where the marble went though. So this was a bit of a surprise to me. I didn't think it would actually go supersonic. It's actually built to shoot marbles, and with marbles it goes nowhere near that fast. And in terms of materials for this airgun, this is all out of parts that you can get from the Home Depot, except for this, which is the valve off of a bicycle inner tube.